Please welcome one of Australia's finest legend stand-up comedians, George Kapiniaris!
Piss off, I've got to show you.
Where are the Greeks tonight? Where are my Greeks?
Ooh, up the back, they love it up the back.
Where's the Cypriots? Two of you, fantastic. They're like free range Greeks. Where are the Macedonians?
Well, that's nice.
And I know I don't want to say anything mean to anybody tonight. I don't want to be like, getting slapped like Chris Rock at the Academy Awards. Who does Will Smith think he is anyway? A great grandmother? How many times do I have to tell you not to say nothing about alopecia when I tell you Putin? You know what worried me? Chris Rock didn't even cry. I would have gone, I didn't do nothing. Tell Dad, you bitch! Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, give yourselves a big round of applause for being so wonderful, wonderful tonight. And we've got skits! We've got Aussies! Where's the fun?
Hello, Yvonne. Welcome to our country. Thanks for coming up.
Love it here. Because I want everyone to be happy tonight. Everyone to be happy tonight because 2020, 2021, they were shit years. Why? Because we did fuck all, basically. They were shit unless you're Greek. Why? Because Greeks like to do fuck all. Yes! There's even a Greek song, it goes like this.
Then bow within the
song means translated? What does it mean? I'm not going anywhere. I'm staying here and doing fuck all. Because Jesus said to the Greeks, don't do anything until I get back. And we haven't. We've done nothing. Still waiting for Jesus to come back. Jesus Christ, when's he going to come back? He's like, don't worry, my luck, I have another cigarette. You want for frappe? You know, for me, 2019 was a shit year. You know why? Because I had three operations. I had a hernia operation. I'm not swearing in Greek, by the way. This is where I just there. Would you stop looking at my penis, madam, while I'm trying to do the story? And then that's why I got jealous. So I had another operation there. Look disgusting! They look like hairy GT stripes. In the nude, I look like an Asian elephant with a mustache. Or as my wife said, a baby Asian elephant. They look terrible. They look like, you know how fish have the gills? I've got gills on my groin. I've got groin gills. And they work, because if I stand in water up to here, I can still breathe. They work. And then I had the worst operation of them all. I broke my collarbone in Greece and I had to get a plate put in there. I know us Greeks like smashing plates, but I had to get a plate put into my collarbone. Greece didn't break my heart. It broke my frickin' clavicle. Why? Why did you go to Greece for all that? Why? Because I had to justify to my boys, my two boys, 14 and 10 years old, they were 2 years younger then, why they have to go to Greek school. That's why. How many Greeks are there in tonight? Exactly. How many clap your hands if you're Greek? Come on. How many of you guys have to go to Greek school? All of you. 100%. How many Lebanese and Italians in tonight? guys had to go to Lebanese and Italian school. Yeah. None of you, bullshit. I'm not talking about during the week, I'm talking about on a Saturday when all the other kids are playing sport. And you've got to go to school. Oh, what did you do on Saturday, Shane? Oh, I kicked the footy and you do, Spiros? Oh, I learned about the Byzantine Empire and how Helen Troy was a big putana. Why do we have to go to Greek school, Dad? That's what my kids were saying. Why do we have to go to Greek school? And I gave them a very good reason, a very good educated, sensible reason. I said, because Mummy and Dad had to go, so you're going too, motherfuckers. No. I said, because Mummy and Daddy going to take you guys to Greece for a holiday. Greece, it's like Bali, but with Greek people, for a holiday. And you're going to meet all your cousins in Greece, and all your uncles and aunties, you're going to make new friends, and you're going to have to communicate in Greek. That's why you go to Greek school, so you can communicate in Greek. We went to Greece for a holiday, the Greeks spoke better English than my kids. And when they spoke Greek, it sounded like this. I thought they were Albanian. That's a shit holiday. I hated that holiday. My kids complained the whole time. Complaining the whole time. Dad, mummy, boy, dad. We're in Athens, in a hotel in Athens with the view of the Acropolis and the Parthenon. Just down there. I go to the boys, hey boys, check out the Acropolis. They go, hey dad, check out the Wi-Fi. It's shit. We can't even get a YouTube in the Acropolis. Every time my wife and I wanted to do something a little bit romantic, something would go wrong. Where in Athens, my son gets gastro and spend the next five days in the hospital in Athens. We go to Milos, beautiful island, Milos 75, fantastic beaches with crystal clear water, and there's fish, the botcher with the fucking feet over there. My son jumps in, he hurts his neck. We spend the next days in physio in Milos. We go to Santorini, the most exciting, the most beautiful, romantic island in the universe. We went there, we wanted a hotel room with a swimming pool. Our room got flooded 4 o'clock in the morning. We had to eat all fucking swimming pool. My son thought he pissed himself. Oh no, sir. Drank a lot of water last night. And some Albanian guy cleaning up 4 o'clock in the morning. I said, I thought he was Greek. And then I thought our luck would change when finally we ended up in Thessaloniki in the north of Greece. Thessaloniki, it's not like that. And I was so excited because I managed to score 2 tickets to the European Champions League qualifier, Pulp versus Ajax Amsterdam. I'm jumping around the house. I'm so excited. My kids are telling me to calm down. Calm down, Dad. You've had too much red cordial. Calm down. What have you been drinking? Let's see that again. What's going on? But I used to get excited when I was a little kid, 5-year-old kid. I used to get excited. What now? 5-year-old, I used to get excited over Miss Pat on Romp Room. Clap your hands if you remember Miss Pot. Miss Pot. Too much white, I can't remember it. Yvonne, you remember Miss Pat, don't you? She was like the Wiggles, but there was one of her and she was hot. Anyway. And she used to sing, bounce, bounce, bounce the ball. I wanted to bounce my balls. I didn't have balls yet, I was 5 years old. I had a hairy back, no balls. I had sideburns, no balls. I had a beard like Conchita from Eurovision Song Contest, no balls. I don't think he's got balls either, anyway. So I said to the kids, come on, let's go get something to eat while we wait for the soccer to start. Come on. They go, Dad, we don't like Greek food, it's shit, we hate it. That's my fault, because I said to the boys, when we go to Greece for a holiday, every day you're going to be having Victoria Gyros from America. You're going to be having that kebab souvlakis, Victoria Gyros. Every day, every time we went to some Greek relative's house to visit, you know what we had? Fucking vegan food. Bumyas. You know what bumyas are? Yeah, okra. I'm not talking about that woman in America that does a TV show. Okra. Okra. You know what okra is? It's beans that have been rolled in snot and hair from the hairdressing salon. He keeps, eat that. That's Greek McDonald's. Better than nuggets. Try that. I said to my Greek relatives, what the fuck is going on here? What is going on here, the Greeks? In Australia, we eat meat every day. That's what we eat every day. For breakfast, lunch and dinner, meat. That's what we eat, meat and more meat. What's going on here? What's going on? They go, you know, the farts from the chaos are killing our planet.
I said, really? Okay, what do vegans eat every day? What do they eat? Beans, all day long. Soy milk, beans, tofu, beans, all day long. What do beans make you do if you eat them all day long? They make you fart all day. You know what I say? Kill the fucking vegans. I said to the kids, come on, let's go do something. Drop the iPads. We didn't come to Greece for you guys to look at iPads. We came to Greece for you guys to look at Greece. Because my kids can't do anything without the iPads. They can't even take a shit without the iPad.
Dad, bring the iPad, I'm constipated, Dad.
The iPad is a laxative in our house.
Dad, I can't do a turn without the iPad, please. I'm pushing, I need some visual stimulation, please, Dad.
They can't have their dinner without the iPad. They can't watch TV without the iPad. They can't sit in the car unless there's an iPad on their lap in the car. This isn't just my kids. This is 75% of children all around the world. When I was a kid, we didn't have an iPad in the car. We didn't have a car. We had to borrow Giovanni's from next door. And then there was 50 of us in the car. I didn't get a seat until I was 17 years of age. I used to have to sit on the gears and move the gears for my dad doing the Macarena. Hey, Macarena! I said to the kids, drop the iPads, let's go do something. Look, across the road, there's a soccer pitch. Let's go and kick the soccer ball. Two kicks in. Me and my big mouth, two kicks in. I'm the goalkeeper. My son kicks the ball. I dive for the ball. I dive straight into the goalpost and crack my fucking neck like a Sayo cracker, bite-sized. Because in Greece, the goalposts aren't painted white like everywhere else. They're painted black like this, so you can't fucking see them.
And I'm going, oh no, I've broken my collarbone. Oh, what you shouldn't do when you break your collarbone. Oh, my wife's going, oh no, we're going to have to cancel our holiday in Greece. I'm going, oh no, I'm going to have to cancel my soccer tickets.
And this is the power of the mind. This is the power of the brain. I managed to convince myself that that lump on my shoulder wasn't a broken bone. It was just a bruise, just a tiny little bruise. And even though it was the size of my head, I looked like I had two heads. I looked Tasmanian. So I got my finger and I pushed that lump down where it came from. And I grabbed my son, my 10-year-old son, and I said, and off we went to the soccer to see the European Champion League qualifier, Bolx versus Ajax Amsterdam. And that was the most feral ground I have ever been to in my whole life there in Thessaloniki. It was like a scene out of Mad Max. All the supporters are wearing black t-shirts, like Penrith supporters, but instead of no teeth, they've got no gums to hold on to the teeth. Feral. Instead of security guards, they've got bouncers. And I realised that we're sitting in Gate 4, the most notorious gate in the whole of Europe, Gate 4, Thessaloniki, Balk, Thessaloniki. All the chairs are kicked in, there's holes in the wall. And we climb up to the top. Climb up, worse than a Kemba. We climb up to the top to find our seats. And there's a woman with a blue top, covered in tattoos, with a short haircut, smoking a cigar, sitting in our seats. Next to her, there's a guy with one eye. Next to him, there's a guy who looks like a mangy cat. And next to him is a bald guy who's topless. He hasn't got a top on, but he's got a ponytail from the back of his head all the way down to his arse crack. I'm not sure if the ponytail's starting from the arse crack or the back of the head. And I've gone in Greek. I'll do it first, it sounds better in Greek. Signomi kiriamo, alla numizoe ote hete kaiti melathos, numizoe ote hete kathisita kathismatas. Which means, I said, so sorry, madam, terribly sorry. I think you've made a tiny little mistake. I think you might be sitting in our seats. To which she's replied, Mr. Vlepomen numera, I kathismata sti thira tesra, and that's it! When she did that, I did a little wee in my pants. My 10-year-old said, Dad, I'm scared, but I'm excited too. What she said was, I don't give a fuck about seats or seat numbers, malaka. I said, that's okay. When you're around here, we'll could just sit over here. My son and I, both of us, would sit in the one chair. We didn't even get to sit down. Because in gate four, at Dubai Stadium, it's so nicky, it fits 4,000 people. Gate four, they managed to cram in 20,000 people. You don't ever get to sit down. Everyone's standing up and singing. Pao kara, pao kara, saga po. Clap your hands. Pao kara, pao kara, saga po. 2, 2, 1. Pao ima sine bro. Pao kara, ima rossi rope. Pao kara, pao kara, saga po. And me and my son are clapping along like you guys. And then the X-ray lyric started. Mia ho rea petaluda, mia ho rea petaluda, mia ho rea petaluda, to munitis mana shu, which is translated. Now you know where the Greeks are. I'll do it in Italian first. Una bella farfallina, una bella farfallina, like that thing in your mutandis. It's basically, for the Macedonians, something, something, pichka. On this show doesn't come with subtitles, so I'm going to have to translate for you too. Your mum's vagina looks like a butterfly. It's what we were singing! My 10-year-old didn't even know what we were singing, but he's singing all the words. Your mum's vagina looks like a butterfly. Your mum's vagina looks like a butterfly. And then you won't believe what happened next. All the players came onto the ground and they all lit up. The whole crowd lit up, all 20,000 of them. I'm not talking about cigarettes, I'm talking about joints, I'm talking about hydroponics, I'm talking about kalamata carrots, I'm talking about baseball bats. This isn't young people, this is old people, all the people. Parents holding on to their children, smoking joints, Greek grandmothers breastfeeding their grandchildren. There's a green cloud, a green cloud over the top of Gate 4. And there I am, with my 10-year-old son, sucking in the fumes. What kind of a parent am I? But I tell you what, I tell you what, I had no more pain in my shoulder. And my son was hungry for the first time, Chris. He went home, he had 4 plates of bunnies, 5 toasted sandwiches. And it wasn't even our place, it was someone else's. We didn't give a fuck where we were. But there is a word that we learnt in Greece, a brand new word. It's the only word we learnt, really. And that's the special word that starts with an M. I've said it a couple of times. Do you know what that word is, boys and girls? Malacca is very good, not even Greek. Malacca. You know what that word means, Malacca? Daniel Andrews. Very good. Anyway, what's Malacca in Italian? It's a stronzo scemo. Stronzo scemo. And it's in English, Malacca. That's a Malacca. He's a stronzo scemo, wanker. He's a stronzo scemo. He's a stronzo? The Sicilians are saying stronzo, the Calabrese are saying scemo. No, scemo is something you clean your Ferrari with, so it must be stronzo. Anyway, it doesn't matter. But they love that word in Greece. Everybody's saying that word. Kids in Greek school, Malacca. I can't see the blackboard, you Malacca. The priest in the Greek church, prosexetigriare Malacca. Lovers in Athens, I love you, Malacca. Country filled with malacca's. And my son asked me, my young son, he was 8 at the time, he's a bit older now, but he asked me, Dad, what does that word mean? They say it all the time, malacca, what does that word mean? Well, I couldn't say wanker, malacca, could I? As an 8-year-old son. So I said, well, John, a malacca. Malacca. A malacca is someone that wants to be alone with their thoughts. Somebody else said that. Okay. Tick Lasso said that. No, I said, I wasn't that good. I said, John, I'm a lucker, I'm a lucker, I'm a lucker. I'm a lucker. It's mine. And. Okay. Is there. I'm lucky. John, lucky. As I'm saying in Lebanese, zup. That's why you guys like Subway. Penis Yvonne, pee, keep up! Down the pants,
Dougie. He said, Dad, that sounds like me. I go, that sounds like Daddy too. That's why Daddy became an actor. Anyway, that's my son John, always asking questions. Even when he was a little boy, he was asking questions. Even recently, he said to what he said to us the other day, Dad, when are you and Mum going to do something about climate change? I said, the bigger parsley, Anthony Albanese. Climate change, when are you and Mum going to do something about it? I said, don't you mean climate change? He goes, climate change, I can hear you down the end of the hallway. It sounds like someone's dying in there. I'm starting to have nightmares. I said, that's Daddy's Mum, doesn't make those sounds anymore. That's my son John, who at 4 years of age asked me this one. Wait till you hear this one in the bathtub, and he's stretching it and stretching it. And you guys don't have them anymore, do you? You cut them off, don't you? You guys cut them, you gather them up, you stitch them together, you make a little wallet, you go on holidays, you rub them, they become a suitcase. If you're Lebanese, you rub them, you get a genie. He's in the bathtub, he's stretching it. 4-year-old stretching it. He goes, Dad, what's that? I said, that's your foreskin. He said, when I'm 5, I'm going to get a 5-skin. Took for a holiday in Hawaii. That's how we say Hawaii. Hawaii, because I'm Greek. Because my Greek heritage, we have no problem saying Hawaii. I have no problem with all the names over there. Hawaii, Honolulu, Wakalin, Waikiki, Alamuana. Because my Greek heritage, no problems. I said to my wife, pick any sign. I'll pronounce it for you. Look at this sign. It says Onewate, because of my Greek heritage. I have no problem saying Onewate like that. So easy for me to say Onewate. She goes, mate, it's one way. They're American. They speak English, my mother. That's why the cars are facing in one way. We're at the Hilton Hawaii swimming pool. And John's in the pool, my son's in the pool. And then he's doing bohemies, right? And he's doing chisha. Right? And he's like, shato. How do you say chisha in Lebanese? Subjuice. Anyway. It's so funny when wogs speak secretly, you sound like Yogi Bear. Then I'm not gonna do it in the pool. The kids are gonna make fun of me. I'm gonna do it in the pool, Dad. That's why us Greeks call it a piscina, because you're piscina. It's a piscina. Turn around for 1 second, he's doing it in the pool. But from the diving board, it's a true story! Little mini melon. No, that's wrong. That's bad. I shouldn't be doing that. My dad would be so upset with me if he was alive today, hearing me saying all those words. My luck, I wasn't allowed to say malaka. When I was a boy, I wasn't allowed to say malaka. I wasn't allowed to say re malaka. I wasn't allowed to say re. Is that the malaka? What is it? A re. I had a friend called Ray. He wasn't allowed in the house because he said, like, once I said to my dad, oh, come on, Red, like that, come on, Red. He kicked me out of the house for saying, come on, Red. He was saying, like, Red, kick me out of the house. Don't laugh. He kicked me, like, out of the house. I'm talking about my suitcases were on the front doorstep and he kicked me out of the house and had to live in the garage. Because my dad, he didn't hit me like all the other ethnic kids. He used to hit all the other ethnic kids, no. My dad, he didn't hit me. All he did was make the Robert De Niro face and I would shoot myself. That's what I called it. My name's Greg. But he'd make that face and look like Robert De Niro with a helicopter movement. And I would cacare my pantaloni. That's an Italian phrase. And he'd shit in bricks. There'd be so many bricks coming out of my ass, you could build a double story brick in your house in Melbourne. With columns. You could see the columns coming out. He did the Robert De Niro face with a helicopter movement. He'd do even when he was cleaning the car with the Chamois. Shit myself. Pop in the wind.
Go see your mother, you dog, and don't mess up my car, don't come on. I didn't know what the fuck he was talking about.
He sounded Albanian.
Talking to me.
shit myself! Run into the backyard, he chased me to the backyard, I go up the tree.
Get down. 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 I've got 2 words to say to you. Damn.
Get down! Get down! Get down! The Aussie next door neighbour thought my dad was like the Greek James Brown. Get down! Get on up! Like a big machine! Living in Australia! But I wouldn't get down. I'm not stupid. It's not in my locker! I would jump into the other next door neighbour's house, which is my granddad's house, and I'd get away with everything! Because great granddads, they don't chase you around the house. They buy you the house. After two weeks living in that garage, I was starting to get a little bit hungry. I hadn't eaten for 2 weeks. So I thought I'd go visit my mummy. And my daddy was at work, the TAB. And I walked in through the door, my parents' house. And my mum missed me so much. She was dying on a deathbed. Dying. Don't you mum? Is that you? I'm so sick. Oh, I'm so sick. 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 So mommy can see you better. You're so skinny, man. You want mommy to get out of the deathbed? I'm dying, I'm so sick, I'm dead. You want mommy to get out and make you something just a little bit, not too much. Not too much. Just a little bit to make you something, maybe before I die, before I drop dead, before you bury me in the grave. With a tombstone, you want mommy to get up? I'm blind, I can't see. You want mommy to get up? Make you something just a little bit. Just a little snack before I die. Just a little tzatziki, shulaki, steak, yarnaki, tomato, salada, patata, fata, kota, kortas, panakota, kafe, salada, macaronada, putifuria, kuluria, kurabiades, kefteades, baklavaki, melo, macarona, super fruta, yada, statu, da, kolo, kifi, te tribi, diga, lo, tuburu, kifi, stiki, just a little bit. Place. I just came by to say hello. Just came by to see how you go with it. Came by to see if my ironing and my washing's ready yet, is it? And it would be. It would be. Because mums, not just Greek mums, all mums. Maybe not Yvonne, but maybe. On how the de facto feels about it. And I love you. Unconditionally. That's without condition. That's why they put the un in front. That's what my mum loves. She loves me because love's bullshit now. Love is rubbish. Love is nothing now. Love is nothing. Now to fall in love and get married, what do you have to do? You have to go on one of those stupid TV shows with the girls with the sausage lips and the tattoos on the arm. Or bisexual, you don't know if you're coming or going, sir. Not that I've got anything against marriage equality, I'm all for it, but it's just I'm from another generation, there's things I don't understand. For example, if a Greek girl marries another Greek girl, know what I'm saying? Like, who pays for the wedding? The father of the bride or the father of the bride is what I'm asking you. Stupid shows on TV about love. What about that show where someone gets down on his knee and proposes to a total stranger? A total stranger! The last time I heard about that was my grandparents. But I do love The Bachelorette. That's still my favourite show on the TV, especially the series with Sophie Monk, because I love Sophie Monk because she's so hot. A bit like you, Yvonne, so hot. She's got a beautiful body and the blonde hair. And how about that sexy voice? I love Gina as real nice guy. His name was Casserole, it's been a classic. And it's got carrots in it. Carrots. Yeah, Sophie Monk. Why wasn't there a Greek guy? Or a Lebanese guy? An Italian guy? A Macedonian guy? Eh? Asian guy? Eh? On Love Island. Imagine Spiro introducing his mum to Sophie Monk. On Love Island.
Hello, Gil. How are you? Sophia? You Greek? No? Too bad, no worries. You like to cook Sophia in the kitchen? You like to cook in the kitchen? I've got a nice kitchen, $40,000 kitchen in the garage. And then I've got another kitchen, $60,000 in the house. Never used it once, still in the box. You like to cook Sophia in the house? You like to cook?
No, we get Uber Eats, they're our sponsor.
Well, you like to clean the house, not only on top, underneath too. Underneath too. You like to clean the house?
No, we get a cleaning lady every second Tuesday to change the pillowcases.
Yes, that's all right, because you know, us Greek girls are very good cleaners. Italian girls, very good cleaners. Cypriot girls, very good cleaners. Macedonian girls, very good cleaners. Lebanese girls, very good cleaners. Maltese girls, very good cleaners. Russian girls, a little bit putanish now, very good cleaners. Chinese girls, very good cleaners. Japanese girls, very good cleaners. Australian girls?
Good swimmers, aren't they?
And we watch those shows together. And we'd cry together with my mum, because we're human. We're human, you can't use that word anymore. Human, that's a special word that you can't use. It's an offensive word now. And if Labour gets in, you can fuck that word off forever. You won't ever use it again, because it's offensive, because I've got man in it. That's a word we can't use anymore. Man, oh, that's because of gender sensitivity and gender neutrality. We can't say the word man anymore, so we're going to have to change the whole dictionary. So instead of humans now, we're going to be hue persons. That's what we're going to be. Change the whole dictionary, so instead of a mandarin, it's going to be a persandarin. And instead of a doberman, it's going to be a dober person. No, it's a dog, no, it's a person, make up a mind. But you know what? We can't be hue persons. It's got person in it, and son, it's got son. In the person, there's a word son, which is a little man, which is a baby man. Fuck him, motherfucker. It's a little baby man. Human Charles, so now we're Cupid Charles, that's what we are, we're all Cupid Charles, and my wife is a woman, is a Wumpa Child, I'm married to a Wumpa Child, I'm married to a Wumpa, 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 and when she gives us face to them, she looks like an Oompa Woompa, and you know what, it's going to be mandatory, but it can't fucking be mandatory, got a man in it, my lucker, so it's going to be pejorative, and then the tree hunters French is first, and you're going to get fucked off with this, because it is, alone. What's wrong with you? 5% of the community are running out of business. Piss off! What did some dickhead say? The other day to us that we should stop? It's probably your daughter, Yvonne. She should stop. We should stop having children because they're killing our planet. My kids aren't killing the planet. They're killing each other on Fortnite. That's what my kids are doing. They're playing Fortnite and TikTok dancing. That's what we do now.
Wow, you can't really dance.
That's what we do. Even me, I'm doing TikTok dancing now. I'm a professional TikTok dancer. Don't know if you knew this before you came tonight. I'm a professional TikTok dancer. I've got a sponsor now. The federal government have been paying me $3,000 JobKeeper for 2 years to be a professional TikTok dancer. 2 years. My wife loves JobKeeper. She says I've made more money in the last 2 years than my whole career as a stand-up comedian. 35 years. Because my wife thinks we're rich now.
Because while I've been doing TikTok dancing in the back room, she's been doing online shopping in the office. The house is filled with boxes everywhere, boxes and packages. I can't find the kitchen anymore. Where is it? The house is covered in boxes. I've got a Fatini. What's in this box over here? She goes, shoes. I go, okay, so what's in this box over here? She goes, more shoes. I go, right, yeah. So what's in this box down here? Even more shoes. Oh, really? And how much were the shoes? She said, 50% off. I said, that's not a price, that's a percentage. How much were the shoes? She said, they were cheaper than those shoes. I go, all right, how much were those shoes? She said, 30% off. Do the maths. I said, don't play that game with me. That's the 50% off game. That's the game I play with my mum when she comes to our house and visits and asks what everything's worth, like the TV that time when she came to our house and asked her how much the new TV was worth. I'm going to say $4,000. She's going to write me out of the will. I'm going to say $2,000. Still she complained. Still she opened the front door of the whole neighbourhood and she said, my son, the Malacca just made $2,000 on a television! Because my mum will buy anything that's marked down. But my wife is the same, but she's got more expensive taste. She goes to Myers and David Jones and does the same thing. The other day she wanted to buy the escalator because it was marked down. We had a huge argument. She got so upset because she lost the credit card. She couldn't do any more shopping. The bank called me up a week later. They said, we found your wife's credit card. I said, I do feel sorry for my wife, because 2 years in Melbourne, we broke the record. We were locked down the most in the whole world, and sometimes we couldn't leave 5 kilometres from the house, and both times my wife had a birthday, so I couldn't buy her a present, because I couldn't leave 5 kilometres from the house, and Westfield is 5.2 kilometres. We didn't want to get arrested. So I said to my wife, I said, honey, I'm so sorry. I wanted to buy you a present for your birthday twice. But because of the lockdown, I couldn't leave the house to buy you a present. She goes, honey, that's okay. I bought myself a present. I said, really? I said, what did you buy? She said, pick a box. My wife thinks we've won the lottery now. She thinks we won the lottery because of that bloody JobKeeper. She thinks we are loaded. We're poor and we're fucking loaded. She's buying furniture, light fitting, sound systems, guitars, everything, clothes. And I can't believe the other day she said this one to me. We need a new car. I said, what's wrong with the car that we got? She goes, it doesn't work anymore. I go, it doesn't matter. We're in lockdown. Petrol's expensive. We don't need it anymore. She goes, we need a new car. I said, all right, let's get a second-hand car. She goes, I'm not putting my key into somebody else's hole. I want a virgin car. I said, that's funny, because when I met you, you weren't a Virgo. I said, why don't we get a Japanese car? She goes, I can't speak Japanese. A German car. I said, can you speak German? She said, yeah. Just a little Audi. A VW. A tiny little VW. Maybe a BMW. My friend Stefania. She's got a Mercedes. It drives itself and it parks itself. I said, does it pay for itself? She said, no. She goes, all right then. We're not getting a Mercedes. So off we go to BMW. How did she do that? See, buying a car with my dad was so much easier. First, you need the cash in your hand. There it was. You go down the car yard. You see the car you like. If you didn't like the colour, you paint it later. Mission brown, like the fence. You go up to the car, you kick the tyres, the car didn't fall over, you get it. That's how he picked my mum. I can't believe my wife said this because I'm the tight ass in the family. She said, don't rush into anything. Make sure you take the car for a test drive and don't go for the first offer. But as soon as that car salesman opened the front door and she got a whiff of the carpets and the leather, she went, oh, I'll take it. He goes, what about tinted windows? Oh, I'll take it. He goes, what about seat warmers? Oh, I'll take it. He goes, what about reverse parking? Oh, I'll take it. He goes, what about paint protector? She goes, oh, I'll take it. I go, wait a minute, paint protector? We have to pay for the paint now? What's wrong with the paint that's already in the car? Doesn't it protect it? He goes, mate, you need paint protector in case a bird shits on your car. So the last time a bird shat on my car, I never asked her out again. My wife's not listening to any of this. She's bending over, checking out the new rims, the black on black Lebo pack rims of war. She's loving them. She's loving them so much. She does a silent but deadly fart. You know those ones you can't hear them, but like a landmine. Anyway, she gets up and she goes, "How much for everything?" The car salesman goes, "Well, your father, when you saw the rims, you're going to shit yourself when you hear the price." She didn't. I did. Anyway, I don't want to talk about it anymore, ladies and gentlemen. It's time to go to the break. Have you had a good first half? But we'll be back for more in the second half. Make sure you come and say hello during the break. We'll be selling some merchandise too. We've got the Acropolis Now box sets. We've got the t-shirts. Oh my God, Harry Watt. Crazy Rich Malakas. Come up and say hello. But for now, I want to leave you with my dance, my work for the last 2 years. Are you ready for it, ladies and gentlemen? Here it is, my TikTok dancing spectacular. If you love it, you can record it, okay? Record it with your phones, I don't mind. And if you love it, put hashtag George Kapiniaris. If you hate it, hashtag Sushi Mango. Here we go.
Oh.